Hello everyone, it's Catherine Chahar here again, and in today's training video we are going to be looking at geometry in lower key stage 2. So in our last video we explored that geometry is a branch of maths and it studies the sizes, shapes, positions, angles and dimensions of things. So let's start off today in year 3. So in year 3, children will be expected to use accurate mathematical language to describe a range of symmetrical and non-symmetrical shapes. And that includes drawing 2D shapes and making 3D shapes. It includes identifying angles greater or less than a right angle, and identifying horizontal, vertical, parallel, and perpendicular lines. So let's start by looking at drawing 2D shapes. So when drawing a 2D shape, we have to think about how we can describe it. So we need to be asking ourselves the questions, how many sides does it have? How long are the sides? How many vertices or corners does it have? Does it have lines of symmetry? And does it have parallel sides? And parallel sides are sides of a shape that never meet or touch. So if we look at this example here at the bottom of the rectangle, we can see that it's got 4 straight sides, it's got 4 vertices, 4 corners, it does have 2 lines of symmetry, and there are 2 sets of parallel lines. And the parallel lines are indicated with the little arrows on there as well. So here are a couple of examples, including the measurement length. So for example 1 is draw a shape that has 4 equal sides, that are 3 centimetres long, and has 4 right angles. And we'd ask, what's the shape called? And we know that it's a square, and the big hint there that it's got 4 equal sides. So it says to give us the hint of draw the 3 centimetre base first, then measure the right angles at each end, and then draw the other sides. And again, it's the same process for the right angle and for the triangle. So think about the number of sides, the length of the sides, and the angles within there. Looking at 3D shapes, so a quick recap, we know that a 3D shape has a length, a width, and a height. And we know that a 3D shape has got a face, and that's a flat surface in a 3D shape. We know it's got an edge where two faces meet, and a vertex is where a corner is a corner where edges meet. And there's some examples of some common 3D shapes that you'll have seen in the previous video. But now we're going to be moving on to making 3D shapes. And there's 2 different ways that we'll be looking at making 3D shapes. So the first one is by joining sticks together, for example, cocktail sticks or straws or lollipop sticks, to make 3D shapes. And it's asking ourselves these questions as we go. So it's describing the shape using edges, faces, vertices, and any curved surfaces, for example, a cylinder, a cone, or a sphere. Talking about what's the same and what's different. And then we've got to talk about what each object in that shape represents. So what does the straw or the stick represent? What does the Play-Doh or blue tack represent? Okay, and another way of looking at it is looking at the net of a 3D shape. So a net of a 3D shape is what it looked like is if we opened up a 3D shape and opened it up flat. And a net can be reversed and folded up to make a 3D shape. So here are 6 examples of some common nets for 3D shapes. And children can begin to identify the 3D shape based on their net. Going to be introducing angles now. And we've spoken in the previous video about turns and quarter turns, half turns, 3/4 turns, and full turns. And now we need to be relating these turns to angles. So we know that the meeting of 2 lines is called an angle. And all angles are measured in degrees, and we use a protractor to measure them. A circle is a complete rotation, and that's 360 degrees. So in half a rotation, there's 180 degrees, and 90 degrees in a quarter rotation. And we note that an angle that measures 90 degrees is called a right angle. And if you look at the diagram in the bottom left corner, we can see that a right angle is marked using a small square in the corner. And a right angle is where it's the joining of 2 perpendicular lines. So perpendicular is 2 lines that meet at a right angle there. And we can show that when we're doing the turns, the quarters, a half, 3/4, we can show the different intervals of 90 degrees on each. So we're looking at lines now. So there are four different descriptions of lines that we need to be making sure that children in year three are using accurately. So we've got the vertical lines, that's straight up and down. We've got the horizontal lines, which is straight line left and right on the horizon. We've got parallel lines. So they are lines that will never meet and are always the same distance apart. And they can be marked by using the little arrows that you can see on the diagram below. Now, if you've got more than one set of parallel lines, all you do is increase the number of arrows. So if, for example, on the rectangle that we saw previously, one set of parallel lines had one arrow and the other set had two arrows to show that they are the parallel lines. And as we've just mentioned about perpendicular lines, they are lines that meet and meet at a right angle. So moving on to year four. So in year four, children will be expanding their knowledge of properties of shape and they'll be describing the positions of shapes on a coordinate grid. So this will include comparing shapes, such as quadrilaterals and triangles, based on their properties and sizes, being able to draw mirror images of shapes in lines of symmetry, and plotting points and describing how shapes move on a coordinate grid. So let's start off by classifying and comparing shapes. So if we start off with triangles, we can classify triangles by their sides. And at the moment in year four, there are the three different types of triangle there that we will be looking at in terms of sides. So the first one is an equilateral triangle, and that's where all sides are the same length. The second one that we'll look at is an isosceles triangle, where two sides are the same length. And the third type is scalene, where all sides are of different lengths. We can also classify triangles by their angles. So we've got an acute triangle, which is where all angles within there are less than 90 degrees. We've got an obtuse triangle, where there is at least one obtuse angle greater than 90 degrees. And a right angle, where there is one right angle in the triangle which is equal to 90 degrees. So there's two separate ways there that we can compare and classify and group triangles. We also need to be able to compare and classify quadrilaterals. Now, a quadrilateral is simply a shape with four sides, quad meaning four in Latin. I remember using terms like quad bike, and that helps children understand the four quad. That's how we remember quadrilateral. So there's six common quadrilaterals on here. So we've got the trapezium, an isosceles trapezium. So that's where two sides are the same length on an isosceles trapezium. We've got a parallelogram, a rhombus, a rectangle, and a square. Now, as you can see on these quadrilaterals, we've got angles that have been marked and we've also got parallel lines that have been marked. So looking at angles now, in year four we want to be learning about four types of angles. So we mentioned these previously when we're looking at comparing and classifying triangles by their angles. We need to be looking at these four. So the first one we'll be looking at is an acute angle. And that's an angle that is less than 90 degrees. I always remember it's acute because it is cute, it is small, it is smaller than 90, it is less than 90. We've got a right angle, which we know is exactly 90 degrees and is marked with a little square in the corner. We've got an obtuse angle, which is greater than 90 degrees, but less than 180 degrees. And I remember obtuse by using the word obese. I know that obese is bigger, it's larger. So an obtuse angle is larger or greater than a right angle. And then we've got a straight angle. So that is an angle on a straight line. And that is 180 degrees. And we can link that to when we were talking about turns previously. So we know that a half turn is 180 degrees. And if we look at the diagram of a straight angle there, we can see that it's a half turn shape as well. So looking at lines of symmetry. Now we did touch upon lines of symmetry when we were looking at year two, and that was looking at one line of symmetry on the vertical line. But now we're going to be expanding that and looking at multiple lines of symmetry. So symmetry, we know this, that a 2D shape is symmetrical if a line can be drawn through it in either side is a reflection of the other. So the line doesn't have to just be down the centre. It can be, if we look at the green object on there, it can be in different areas. So that's called a line of symmetry. And sometimes we call it a mirror line or mirror symmetry, because if you put a mirror in the middle, it would show the reflection of the full shape. And we've got a couple of points here. So we know an isosceles triangle has got one line of symmetry, a square has got four lines of symmetry, and a circle has unlimited lines of symmetry. So if we look at the blue objects on here, we can see the two lines of symmetry at the top. And then if we look at the bottom objects, we can see that where a image has been reflected over along the symmetry line, along the mirror line, and you can see where they are opposites of each other. So let's look at coordinates now. So coordinates are two numbers or letters that describe a position on a map, a graph, or a chart. The horizontal coordinate is the x-axis is always written first. And the vertical coordinate, the y-axis, is always written second. Now I remember when I was at school, I was taught the rhyme along the corridor and up the stairs to help which way to help me remember which way to write coordinates. So we go along the corridor first along the x-axis, then up the stairs to the y-axis. So we'll look at this example here on the red dot. The coordinate is 7, 3. So we've gone along 7 and up 3. And we always write coordinates with a bracket either side and a comma in the middle. It doesn't matter if it's a letter or a number, it would be written in the same way. We can also describe positions and movements between positions on a coordinate graph as translations. So that helps us to describe the movement of left, right, up and down. So for example, if we look at the red dot, it was originally 7, 3. But when we've moved it, we've translated it 2 spaces to the right to 9, and we've translated it 3 spaces up to 6. So the new position would be 9, 6. And we can talk about translations as movements. And remember, left, right, up, down. Continuing to look at coordinates, we now need to be able to draw sides to complete a given polygon. Now a polygon is simply a 2D shape that's got 3 or more straight sides. So a triangle, square, rectangle, pentagon, hexagon, they are all simply polygons, as long as it's got 3 or more sides. So we need to be looking at the 4 coordinate points that we've got on the bottom, on the right hand side, so it's our examples, and we then simply put the marks on the graph and then we join them together. Now sometimes you will be given 3 out of the 4 and the children will have to use their mathematical knowledge to complete that shape and put the missing coordinate points in. So thank you very much. That is a whistle stop tour of geometry in lower key stage 2. Please join me again for our next video where we'll be looking at geometry in upper key stage 2. As always, if you've got any questions, please drop me an email. My new email address is here below. And don't forget to complete the form at the end of the session. Thank you very much.